for the optimistic cynic. Shit, ho got a hell of a grip. It's never a problem till niggas is piling and bitches they all.
Yo, YouTube, what's going on? It's D-Boy Classics. And with today's video, man, you can already tell from the title, man, I made a 7-3 max weight pure post score. And I did a poll, I think a week or two ago, about this, asking y'all if you want to see that. It's something different from my rim protector and all. And the majority said yeah, so I'm like, yeah, let me put this together. But basically, I'm just seeing how I really do feel to be a very dominant type of big man, man. So basically, I'm just going to put out some games for you. You see right here, we're facing straight shooters. So sure, for the first game, at least. And this whole video contains just two games. It's not too crazy, just cuckoo games showing how well this post score is. So we've been with the ball. E-Man almost got the steal. They scrambling for the ball. They still recover it. That's okay. I get back on the guy. I switch to the E-Man, man. He shoots and he catches it, bro. It's cool though. The only thing I really hate about this type of center, man, is definitely the lack of defense. Obviously, it's two different things because my main is a rim protector, so I'm used to that. But besides from that, man, two, he's really, really slow, bro. Really, really slow. I'm just not used to that. But it's all right, though. I can adjust to that. You see right here, E-Man playing really good defense, bro. E-Man gets the pluck, but it goes out of bounds once again. Oh, not once again, but it goes out of bounds this time. And, we'll get the ball eventually, bro. So we just got, like I said, we always tell each other, just play good defense. We'll get the ball eventually. So they get the ball back once again. I'm just expecting out the stretch right here. Oh, the sharpshooter, my fault. He gets the ball. He shoots. That's a bad shot. E-Man gets a rebound. Now it's time for me to really test how this post guard is, man. So I go in the post right here. I'm backing down. I do a drop step. Bad take. I understand, but it was actually a shooting foul. I was trying to pump fake, but he jumped at the same time. So besides that, I pass the ball to E-Man. E-Man passes right back. Oh, never mind. He don't pass it right back. He does a drop step himself, showing how it is. And you see, he gets the easy dunk, man. That's the thing. Sharpshooters, it's real. They can get exposed by anyone who's inside in general because, literally, the defense for them is just so bad. It's not even their fault. I mean, they're sharpshooters. They sacrifice the defense for shooting, so that's expected. But jeez. But E-Man gets the rebound. I get the ball back. Now it's time for me to get to work. I'm deciding on the scene. I go into the post. I'm trying to back down. I'm just scanning. I do a hook, and the hook lands. Tell me. Let me ask you all this for all the people who play post scores. Why don't see a lot of people do any hooks? I believe the hooks are pretty good. They're pretty efficient, bro. Especially if people are backing down because they're scared of the drop step or postmans. Besides from phase, the hooks are pretty easy to land in my opinion. But besides from that, I get the ball back again. It looked like they were with the double team, but they don't. I'm just trying to size him up. He reaches and gets the foul. That's okay, man. We still get the ball back. And I told E-Man, yeah, give me the ball back and I just size him up in the post. So I pass the ball to E-Man. E-Man gives me the ball back. Almost fumbled out of bounds, but it's all right, though. I'm just backing out. He overreaching. I do a beautiful layup because he's jumping so much. I do just do up and under. And that's 1 point. Whoa, how many points that is? Oh, I can't. Because we up at, it's 3-9 right now. I'm backing him down. He can't really stop it because it is a miss, but I do a post spin, a pump fake. The other man try to goes in. E-Man takes the layup. Almost made it, but it's like E-Man got that. He got the putback, and that's another point. So the score is 3-11. It's okay. I believe throughout the whole video, I'm gonna get the majority of the ball though, but aside from this, we just moved around. So E-Man gets the ball. His man's playing hands up because E-Man can definitely shoot, and he reaches and gets the foul. We're just looking. It's all right though. So next up, E-Man's gonna pass me the ball, and I'm gonna go back into the post like usual, do my thing, backing him down. He reaches once again. That's all right though. So I'm just gonna get the ball right back. So I pass the ball to E-Man. E-Man passed me the ball right back, I believe. Yep. And I'm going right into the post. I'm just trying to back him down to see the test of the drop step. He switches. I get a green layup because E-Man was a little bit late. Hit the switch off a little bit late. So I was able to get the open layup. E-Man passed me the ball back. I go to the post. I'm backing down once again. Drop step, easy dunk. And you can see at the top, takeover is coming through. So you already know a majority of it for post scorers with their takeover, it's pretty much unguardable, bro. It's unguardable. The thing is, you see they're double teaming, they're spamming me. That's all fair game, bro. Cause like I said, pure post scorers takeover or any post scorer takeover in general is just can't do nothing about that. It's just so, the animation that they get and the stuff they are able to do with it is just insane, bro. Absolutely insane. So I passed the ball to E-Man. E-Man passed the ball right back. I'm saying that he jumps. I do a hook and that goes in, bro. The hook, I'm trying to tell you, the hooks are underrated in my opinion for post score. Definitely in the future when I do more vids with him, I'm gonna show him more showcasing for the hooks. And definitely I'm backing down. I do a post spin. Hook, a fadeaway and cash it for game. So let's get on to the next one. Alright y'all, so game two in the last game of this whole video, man. We're going into the lineup was once again shooters. Shooters once again, it was a stretch and I believe a playmaker sharp. So we see I pass the ball to E-Man. E-Man passes the ball back to me, excuse me. I'm backing down. The shark, he just stay in the paint, so I'm just a little scanning. I'm just filling stuff out. I'm backing down, drop step. Fake pass out to E-Man because his man was helping. E-Man catches it out. So that's how the first possession went for us. So the score is 0-3. So E-Man gets the ball. He passes it right back to me, and we back into the base for the post. I'm backing down. I'm scanning. I do a hook, and it lands. I'm telling you, bro, the hooks are underrated in my opinion for post scores, bro. A lot of people don't realize that. I feel like everyone's do a lot of the fades, but it's respectful. It's respectful. So the stretch of playing hands, I do a post spin. I fake it and go for an easy layup as he jumps. So the score is 0-7 right now. And yeah, it's looking a little ugly. You see my takeover meter is halfway there. So once that takeover kicks in, you already know it's going to get ugly. It's going to get real ugly for the stretch, bro. So E-Man doing his thing. E-Man goes in for the beautiful posterizer. So the score now is 0-9. So I pass the ball to E-Man on the inbound. He passes right back. I'm doing my thing in the post once again. Honestly, I'm still filling out this post score. I still need to get his badges up because I didn't really take the time to max out his badges before the video. So I was just filling them to get a test for it in general. And definitely when he get his badges, bro, he's gonna be a force to be reckoned with. And you see, E-Man got the interception. I'm back in the post against the strip. I do the shimmy, wait, and oh, there we go. I forgot if that went in or not. Sorry. But you see, I did a little shimmy to the up and under, and that went in from the fade. So E-Man doing his thing, he got his life, so he shoots it, and he misses, but I get bored, so I'm back into the post once again. You see right here, so his man is helping, I pass out, E-Man's open, he catches it, oh no, he faked it, he lied on the green, but I got the board, though, it's cool. So I'm playing, you see his man was double teaming, oh, but he was first to score so much, he took it off, that's tragic, that's unfortunate. I do a post spin, I do an up and under, and it goes in, bro. I'm telling you, bro, wait till I get these badges for this post score, bro. The badges with this post score is going to be absolutely insane, bro. I'm going to be just a walking force, bro. E-Man passed me the ball right back. You see the stretch right there. I just want to get some more action. I'll just see what he's going to do. So I'm just going to the paint. His man is helping. He's trying to bait, but I got that. I shoot the far fade, and it catches out, man. And you see at the top, I got my takeover. You already know how to go get down, bro. I know the stress, like, oh my god, he's holding his nuts in the paint, but his teammate got me with the spam, and they got the ball, man. It's cool though. It's unfortunate because I active my takeover, but it's all right though. We do gotta play some good defense. So his man passed him to the stretch going out. He's going left, right. E-Man tried to get him, but he got him with the stop and got him with the easy layup. It's all right though. So his score now is 2-15. So E-Man's been going to the paint once again. He passes out the stretch because I helped, but the stretch bricks, and yeah, that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate though, but you know, you already know what we gotta do right now with this takeover. We gotta just go crazy. So E-Man passed me the ball right back, and the guy just run out of bounds. I believe he just gave up, but you know, his teammate can get this too. So I do the hook. Once again, it lands. It's unfortunate I can't green them. I'm trying to get my best to green them, but they're still going, so I accept it. So E-Man passed me the ball once again. He ran out of bounds. And his teammate rushes me and fouls me once again. And you can see how this game is. The score is 2-17. And he flops. E-Man goes in for the meme posterizer once again, bro. And in general, the game's pretty donezo, bro. So I passed to E-Man. E-Man gets the easy dunk, man. But definitely let me know if y'all liked the video, man. Definitely. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.